Remember in the video about pseudo-classical classing, where I pointed out that there were two different categories of code going on in the car class? This is the exact moment where that distinction becomes extremely interesting. So far, we've made it so that the differentiation code in the subclass will call out to the differentiation code available in the superclass. But due to the fact we're using prototype chains to implement inheritance, we also need to wire up the subclass prototype to the superclass prototype to allow the similarity code to be inherited as well. Amy does delegate to van.prototype, but neither Amy nor van.prototype have any relationship with car.prototype yet. In order to set up that relationship, we want to make it so that van.prototype delegates to car.prototype. This is how we are going to make the shared methods available from car onto van. If we succeed, then a lookup to amy.move will fall through the Amy object and up to the van prototype, which will fail and finally fall all the way through to the car prototype. Ideally, we would be able to update van.prototype such that it would delegate its failed lookups to car.prototype. In memory, we would expect it to work rather like this. The van.prototype object should be made to delegate all the way up to the car.prototype object. In this way, it would be very similar to car instances because both would delegate failed lookups to the car prototype property. But this actually isn't allowed in the official version of the language. Instead, we're going to have to overwrite the originally provided prototype object with a brand new object that we create. So what object exactly do we want to be assigning in place of the old van.prototype object? It might surprise you that pseudo-classical subclasses will work just fine after a reassignment like this. And that's because the instance delegation is set up only when the constructor actually runs. This prototype replacement happens right alongside the constructor definition, and so that's plenty of time before we actually instantiate any objects. People often propose that van.prototype could simply be made to equal car.prototype. But remember, JavaScript doesn't do any copying when you assign one variable or property to be equal to another one. If that was the case, then it would be impossible to add any methods to the car prototype that weren't also on the van prototype, and vice versa. So adding a van.prototype.grab would have the effect of modifying car.prototype to also have a .grab method. In short, we definitely don't want our van.prototype to be the exact same object in memory as the car.prototype object. So instead of making van.prototype equal the same exact object as car.prototype, how can we make sure that the van prototype will delegate its failed lookups to car.prototype? Fill in the code for yourself.